I am sitting in front of the backdrop for tomorrow's meet, Boss of Bosses 5. This is the fifth installment of the meet. I've been the one with my wife putting the meet on since the beginning, the last 5 years. It's been pretty cool to see the level of competition really just take off.
Yeah, the cut was actually pretty smooth, so I was underweight by several pounds. So look at that Wilkes, because you got this guy, you know, crushing all the Wilkes records. So gotta at least give him a run for his money. In the last 24 hours, so you know, I had cut out sodium and carbs and fluids, and so those are the three main things that I'm going to try and put back in today. But as well as, of course, vitamins and nutrients, because since I wasn't really eating or drinking, I wasn't getting any of that stuff in. So, yeah, so it's pretty much, yeah, carbs, complex carbs ideally, as more than sugars, electrolytes, sodium, like I've got salt in there. Rice is probably going to be my main carb up. I made the mistake before of potatoes, but those are a little more filling, so rice is less filling, so I can get more of that in. And then tonight, sushi. Every night before a meet, I've always done sushi. And that's great because it's rice, soy sauce for sodium, and it tastes amazing. So
this is my third year at Boss of Bosses. I did a 20-week prep coming into this. Cut like 13 pounds in the last 4 days leading up to weigh-ins. So I was walking around about 254 at my peak, and then I cut down 241.4.
Weigh-ins went perfect. I made it just on point. I didn't have to cut too much out. I was dieting ahead of time. I'm really excited for tomorrow. This is more than just for myself. This is to prove to myself and other girls out there who was in my position that if I can do it, anyone can do it. It's not just about the numbers. It's about heart and hard work, consistency, dedication. And I want to show to the world that anything's possible if you work hard.
This is the calm before the storm. You can see no one's quite here yet. They're going to be getting ready in the back room for the instructions. They give instructions to anybody because you never know what level the people here are competing at. So they need to know the proper commands for squat, for bench, and for deadlift, because there's specific commands you must follow when you're powerlifting. And sometimes you get really nervous at a meet, so they just make sure to go over the rules, make sure everybody's prepared, and that they kind of set you at ease after going through the stuff.
All right, guys. As always, this meet is all about you. We're just here to call it as fair as we can, make it an even level playing ground for everybody. Any new lifters today? Okay, if you have any questions, call on us. Let's answer all your questions so there's no confusion on the rules.
Over here is the main stage. You can see they did a fantastic job. And every meet starts off with the king of all lifts, the squat. So it's gonna be squat first. After this, after you go through these rounds, it's gonna be bench. And then the show always commences with the deadlift, which is my favorite lift. In regards to the sport of powerlifting, I'm very passionate about it. It's something that I train for, that I believe in, because it's a sport that, you know, you could start from a beginner level and really make, if you're consistent with it and dedicated, you can make some tremendous progress. Hey, pal. How's it going? We were just going over a basic powerlifting competition and how you do all three lifts. If you are going to compete, I'm not competing, but if I was going to compete, I would be doing all three lifts. Eric, how many lifts are you gonna do?
Two.
But we wish him well. We want him to do really well. So the two lifts that he is going to do, he is set to hit PRs.
Thanks.
So I am teasing him, but at the same time, I'm rooting for him and I want him to do really well.
So powerlifting, I love the sport, super passionate about it. It's an outlet for me to push myself. By competing, it forces me to bring out my best. You know, you have a deadline, you have a date, you're lifting in front of people. It's very different than lifting in the gym. You're lifting in front of the judges with certain rules.
You got this, man. Let's go, you deserve it.
You're doing all three lifts on the same day. So it's really a challenge for me. It's all personal. I don't really care who shows up or who I'm competing against. I'm a competitive person, so if there are other people I'm competing against, sure, I'm gonna try and beat them. But it's really for me to push myself.
This is a PR attempt for Eric.
It's what drives me. I'm also trying to fight for the time, and this is the best way to do that. Lifting, the lifestyle, eating good. Quality of life will be so much better. If you're ever thinking about trying a sport, I really highly encourage powerlifting. It's just really awesome. Very different than physique sports in that you get to control your own destiny. In physique sports, it's very subjective. Here, you either lift the weight or you do not lift the weight, so you get to control it. It's much more satisfying. I did bodybuilding years ago, and it's fun, it's cool, but it is not as satisfying to me as powerlifting. Finished up my meet. Only did push-pull, so I didn't squat today. But I went 6 for 6 in the bench and a deadlift. Hit a big PR in the bench, 11-pound PR, and a big PR in a deadlift. It's been 2 years since I've PR'd in a deadlift, so my all-time best prior to this was 565, and we hit 573 today. And I gotta give a lot of thanks to my man, J-Dog. He did my programming for the meet, watched me, critiqued me, and set me up perfect for the meet. I listened to what he said, took his advice, followed his program to the T. He did a program me last year too, and we had a great meet, so I gotta give him a lot of credit. It's great to have him here, on site. Had Skiba here, had Juliet and the crew. Everybody's here, so it's good to have, you know, your hometown people when you're so far away at a meet. It's just a great feeling, man. 6 for 6, you know, without squatting, it's a perfect meet, 6 for 6.
This is the 5th year that we've been putting this meet on. It's one of those things where if you put on a meet and it's better and better and better and really consistent every year, I think it really has a nice like prestige to it. And to have it be the kind of meet where people say, I want to not just be somebody who's lifted a really good total, but I want to have gone to Boss of Bosses and won, you know, my class or won best lifter, something that would be you know, really meaningful. That part is exciting because every year the meet goes on, it lives up to the expectations. You know, earlier this year I had an injury to my bicep and surgery, and that took a few months to heal, and I feel like that's totally behind me now. But at the same time, I just kind of felt like I'm not ready to kind of push my training. It's fun in the gym because I'm a coach too, so I get to watch all the guys training really hard and pushing for PRs and kind of figuring out what works for them, what doesn't work, what do they need to work on. And so seeing that all now at the very end, where they're putting everything together and now all the hard work is translating into, you know, record or PRs and hopefully records for some of them, that is totally just as exciting as competing for me. So, you know, next year I'll have my chance and I will be ready to train and compete, I'm sure. But for now, I enjoy the process of just kind of being, you know, the promoter and the coach and just a fan, really. What's your max?
This, yeah.
Oh, how much can you bench? That's what everybody wants to know. 9 pounds. Wow. I think it's a little more than that. Thank you.
about Pete. Pete's been around for 20 years, and he's just 27 years old, so he really contributed a lot to this sport.
My goal was to squat in the mid-900s, because I hit that in training, and I knew I was capable of it. But on the second squat, which was the intermediate jump, I didn't focus on the cues I needed to focus on, such as keeping my mid-back tight, packing my lats in under the bar. So I missed that, and then, I didn't want to take too much of a risk, so I took the same weight, but I focused on those cues.
My training partners are ridiculously strong. To watch Andrew Herbert compete, 10 feet away from where he usually squats was pretty cool. And to see him break his own world record. Coming off an injury prior to my last meet, I was gonna just do deadlift only. I thought I'd use it as a platform to have a goal to shoot for, to push my rehab, to get my shoulder better. So I was able to do full power, but again, had no real expectations, just get through the meet. Moved well, so it's just a matter of strike while the iron's hot, sort of thing. So actually PR'd my squat.
My T-band snapped.
Your what?
IT-band.
Really?
My third squat, it was freaking easy money. And I got to the bottom and it just went.
Man, I'm sorry to hear that, man.
It's time to bench now, though.
You gonna do it? You gonna bench?
I'm gonna try. Okay. Leg drive's a little sketchy, but what are you gonna do? This is the best squats I've ever felt. Like, I was warming up, squats felt great. I was really excited, everything was feeling good. Opened at 672, moved like nothing, exactly like I wanted it to. Then I went to 733, which again, very easy, easiest it's ever moved. And then for my last one, I went for a 5 kilo PR of 782.6. And I walked it out, everything felt great. Everything was going great. And then I got to the bottom and my IT band on the right side just snapped like a rubber band. So I had to they had to help me out of the bottom. I couldn't move after that. It's really tight right now, but I'm kind of counting my blessings because I avoided any ACL tears or quad tears, anything serious that's going to require surgery. So it's something I'm going to be able to bounce back from, but it's just really frustrating because this is a meet I've put 20 weeks of training into, and it's the best things I've ever felt. That would have been an all-time PR. It wasn't anything out of reach. I felt great, and it just, sometimes there's things out of your control that come up like this. And while it's bittersweet, because I really felt I had that, it's one of those things I'm gonna have to learn some lessons from, as far as maybe not cutting as much weight, not coming in as dehydrated. That could have been a part of it. Training the little muscles like abductors and adductors, and I'll have to come back and probably try more than that weight next time, because I feel very confident about the weight. My body just didn't want to cooperate on it. But on the bench, I'm gonna see what I can do on bench and deadlift. I'm still gonna give them a try. It might be less than what I wanted, but I'm at least gonna see what I can do. Bench, my elbow started acting up. I hit 452. Tried 463 on my third, which I've done before. That's my PR in a meet. But at that point, my elbow was hurting too bad, and I just couldn't control it on the way down. So it really wasn't the day I was looking for, but I did the best I could.
Bench, you know, it's been a long journey. It's been 16 months since I ruptured my tricep. So it's been a long road coming back. You know, still just getting strength in that arm has been a chore. You know, I used to bench 500, now it's, I hit 440, and that was a post-injury PR by 2.5 kilos. So, you know, I'll take it, baby steps.
He's sitting at 2237, 1,015 kilos right now.
I mean, anytime Yuri Belkin's there, you gotta watch him. He takes most people's total on the deadlift platform in the warm-up room, so he's pretty impressive. James Strickland, I think that'll fly under the radar as one of the most impressive totals, because most guys who are big benchers, and he benched well into the 600, can't, like I said, right, like it's not about being a big bencher or squatter or deadlifter, it's about being a good powerlifter, where a lot of benchers get kind of pigeonholed as bench press specialists, but not good powerlifters. And he went 2,100 pounds in sleeves with a 600 plus bench. So I don't know if anyone's ever done that.
Already done, let's go!
it can be hard to just have enough gas in the tank, or even train to have enough gas in the tank to be able to execute, you know, a 900 plus squat and then close to a 900 pound deadlift. So it's like, it can be a pretty draining day, because when you train, you don't have all like the input that you have here. I think that's what really separates the good from the like the great, is their ability to adapt.
The anticipation factor I had coming into the meet was very high. In my mind, I underperformed. So deadlift was where I'm disappointed the most. I did my opener 8:15. Then for the second, I asked for 8:48, which would have given me a 1,000 kilogram total, which is kind of, you know, a special milestone. And I thought I definitely had it in me, and I've hit that in training. But you know, I didn't. You know, my right hand, you know, didn't maintain grip, and you know, I don't know why. I mean, that's something I just have to either figure out, or maybe I won't figure it out, but I just have to, you know, go back to the drawing board. I love, you know, competing on my home turf. My dad was here, which is fantastic. You know, I think the last time he saw me lift was 2 years ago at Boss of Bosses 3. Steffi Cohen, you know, I mean, she's amazing. I'm, you know, proud to have her as a friend. And man, I mean, I could go on for probably hours about the inspiration that a lot of these lifters, you know, give me.
I just finished deadlift not too long ago, and this meet wasn't what I wanted. It wasn't what I was hoping to hit, but I pretty much did the best that I could, and sometimes that's what you have to do. As you get to a more advanced level, things just get so much tougher, because I remember like 2 years ago, I would do 4 full power meets a year, and every meet I would just get better. Everything was coming so easy. And then ever since I got to this more advanced level, I have a lot more bad days, a lot more bad meets. It's just tougher to progress, and I think that's one of the lessons you have to learn. As much as I could, I went 3 for 3 on deadlift and did 8:32 on my last one, which is, you know, far short of a PR. I've done 8:70, but I took what was there, so I was smart about it. You know, you gotta look at the silver lining sometimes. It's like, I got injured, but it was nothing serious. You know, I'm not in the hospital or anything like that. I'm just gonna go back to the drawing board and keep trying, because that's all you can do.
Every time you compete and Pete's there, like, you got someone you gotta keep an eye on, right? Like, he's just, again, someone who might be looked at as a deadlift specialist, but over the years, like, you watch his total just creep up and creep up. Like, he was one of the, I mean, we had maybe a dozen guys total in the 2000s, and Pete did it in sleeve. So most of the guys were wearing knee wraps when they squat, and Pete went well into the sevens on squat and sleeves. So yeah, anytime Pete shows up and can have a good day, and I think he was even battling like a bit of an injury coming out of squats. So for him to be able to pull what he pulled at the end, most guys would have just thrown in the towel and packed it in for the day, but he's definitely kind of a seasoned veteran now. He's so used to kind of the like the trials and tribulations of a full power meet that it didn't even seem to faze him. Like you watch him in the warm up room and he just doesn't miss. Like he's so methodical in his technique.
Everything's more or less in place. I just turned 27 yesterday, you know, and it's a far cry from when I was 20 and in my basement. There's gonna be another day. I think I'm just more mature. Like you said, it's the difference from being 20 years old and 27 years old. I've got a lot more life experience. I know that things are gonna be okay one way or another. I know maybe, you know, the next meet, that's gonna be my meet. So I don't let the highs get too high and I don't let the lows get too low.